It's CEO here, and today I'm here to show you why it's very likely we will be getting an update to New Horizons that will introduce the expansion of Nook's Cranny. I've done the research and gathered the proof, but of course, let me know in the comments your thoughts if Animal Crossing will be getting a further update or not. But first, if you're new to the channel, my name is CEO, and I also do Animal Crossing live streams on Twitch. Before we get into the video, I want to note that I am not purposely trying to nag on the Animal Crossing devs for an update. I'm sure they will never see this video. But I'm also not trying to set my expectations so high just to be disappointed in the end. But this video encapsulates my realistic views about future updates to the game, based off precedents set by previous updates and Animal Crossing games. I love the Animal Crossing series so much that if we never saw another New Horizons update again, I would still be happy. With all that being said, let's get into the video. First, and the biggest clue for an expansion, is that in the second iteration of Nook's Cranny, which is the yellow building, there is a secret set of stairs off to the right. Using a modded switch, I can walk behind the checkout counter and get real close to this area. I can also rotate the camera and see in 360 degrees a view you can't normally access. The stairs look pretty ominous as they ascend into darkness, never to be seen again. But when I rotate the camera, you can see the stairs are fully rendered and quite tall, tall enough to reach a potential second floor. If players using a normal switch can never see the stairs from this angle, then why are they so tall? And why are they complete with textures to make the wood look realistic? From all my previous research I've done in Animal Crossing, it's evident that Nintendo does not put in the time or effort to build out areas and items that no one will ever see. For example, the hardwood and fruit trees look full and lush from the front, but once I turn the camera around, they are hollow and disturbing to look at. Which brings me back to the stairs in Nook's Cranny. Why are they there? What could they be alluding to? If I try to go up the stairs, I'm immediately shot up to the ceiling above the store, where I'm greeted with a suspicious-looking black square. I'm not sure why this is here. I would have expected to just be in the black void around the store and not see anything in particular. This area looks like it could be the start of an expansion to Nook's Cranny, almost like a placeholder for when it gets updated. And the black square doesn't just blend into the void, it has a distinct border and sharp corners, signifying that it's its own entity. In the first iteration of Nook's Cranny in New Horizons, there's also a little secret area off to the left. You could say this was a clue that Nook's Cranny would be upgrading to a larger store, which was in fact true. So we can say there is a good chance a secret area in Nook's Cranny will lead to an expansion. Since that already happened once in New Horizons, it could easily happen again. In every past Animal Crossing game, Nook's Cranny has seen at least two expansions. These include Nook & Go, Nook Way, Nookingtons, and TNT Emporium, which was found exclusively in New Leaf. So it would make sense that the newest and greatest Animal Crossing game would receive at least one more Nook's Cranny update to bring the total amount of expansions to the minimum of two, seen in previous Animal Crossing games. And this brings me to the famous announcement from Nintendo on October 15th, 2021, that the 2.0 update will be the last major free content update. Now there is a lot to unpack here. First, Nintendo said major update. The addition of Brewster's Roost, Harv's Plaza, a brand new cooking mechanic, and 18 new villagers and NPCs is pretty major. So that's our baseline for how Nintendo defines that term. So an expansion to Nook's Cranny, an expansion seen in all previous Animal Crossing games, doesn't seem that major in Nintendo's eyes. Many people took this announcement as there will be no more updates to Animal Crossing, period. But when in actuality, it means no more major updates. Minor updates are still on the table. In fact, we've already had some. On December 15th, 2021, we saw the 2.0.4 update release, which introduced the complete set of the Zodiac figurines, accounting for future years when playing in-game. So it's plausible that Nintendo can introduce updates that add new things to the game, and not just patches. Something we're also missing that would follow the precedent of the Zodiac figurine update are the celebratory balloon arches for the years 2023 and beyond. When I time traveled to January 1st, 2023, we should see a balloon arch for this year, because in previous years, the balloon arch would be purchasable from this menu. But we don't. The only year-specific item we see is the Rabbit Zodiac figurine, which corresponds to the year 2023. So we could see the addition of the complete balloon arch set down the road. And because the in-game clock of Animal Crossing only goes to the year 2061, that would mean 38 iterations of the arch. Why didn't Nintendo add all those celebratory arches when they introduced the Zodiac figurine set? Well, the Zodiac figurine set added just 11 new items. The balloon arches would mean 38 new items, So perhaps Nintendo just wasn't finished with those items yet, and that they'll add them in a future update. So all that information was to support my point that Nintendo can add additional free but minor updates to the game, and the expansion to Nook's Cranny can be seen as minor. Second, Nintendo said last major free update, free being the key word. Of course, 5 seconds later into the direct, we see the announcement of Happy Home Paradise, a paid DLC, which you can look at as a major paid update to the game. But what if we see major paid updates introduced for your main island? Something that would include, let's say, a Nook's Cranny expansion, but something that is all-encompassing. Something like new island types that you can live on and develop, just like your main island. I'm going to do a whole video just about this prediction for a paid major island update, since I do have proof I found in Animal Crossing that predicts this exact type of update. So if you don't want to miss when that video goes live, subscribe to my YouTube channel and tap the bell button to get directly notified. Let me know in the comments if you think we'll see an expansion to Nook's Cranny in the future. All evidence points to yes, but if you have a differing viewpoint, I would love to know your thoughts. And now, all we can do is wait and see what Nintendo does for Animal Crossing New Horizons. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.